can you burn fat in one spot? Can you spot reduce one specific area of your body and really lean out that one given spot? If I were to go to the gym and I were to do 1,000 crunches, would I burn fat around my abdomen? Or if I were to do 1,000 reps on the leg press, would I get a leaner leg? All right, here's the thing. There's a lot of conflicting science, and a lot of people will tell you that it's just purely not possible. I'm from the belief that we don't fully know, but we can look at the data and look at the studies, even the ones that conflict, and we can draw our own conclusions. The important thing to note here is that genetics play a big role, but that doesn't mean that you just chalk it up to genetics and forget about it. I'm going to give you the solutions here that can help you out and help you reach your genetic potential by literally utilizing diet and specific training periods to maximize your genetic potential to burn more fat in a given area. So let's go ahead and let's dive into the first study that breaks down a little bit of this. So the American Journal of Physiology took a look at 10 fasted males. Okay, these 10 subjects did aerobic exercise, and they found that yes, aerobic exercise induced whole body lipolysis, meaning they mobilized more fat throughout their entire body. But they noticed that there was more fat mobilization and ultimately more fat burning in areas adjacent to working muscles, meaning if the legs were moving, there was a slight bit more of fat burning occurring around that area. Or if the arms were moving, there's a slight bit more of fat burning occurring around that area. But does it actually mean that you are really reducing more fat there? Well, in a lot of ways, it does. You see, here's what we have to look at. This study identified that because there's more blood flow, there ultimately was more in the way of catecholamines like adrenaline and epinephrine and those other hormones getting delivered to that area. Now, in case you didn't know, epinephrine and norepinephrine, all these catecholamines are they are the most important thing when it comes down to fat burning. They are what trigger it and turn it on. So in theory, if we have more being delivered to a given area because there's more blood flow, then yes, maybe there is a small degree of fat burning that occurs at a higher level at that place. The other thing is, of course, we have the thermogenic effect, right? Simple physics will tell us that if a muscle is moving, there is going to be a little bit of friction there, which naturally is going to create more heat in that area. Does that mean that more fat will be burned in that area? Well, correlation does not necessarily equal causation, so we don't fully know, because it could just elevate our full core body temperature and have us burn fat all over, which really isn't a bad thing anyway. So let's take a look at another study that breaks it down kind of from the opposite end of the equation, and then we can form our own conclusions and give you solid solutions and steps that you can take from an actionable standpoint. So this study was published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research. Took a look at 7 men and 4 women in this particular study. Okay, and it had them for 12 weeks go to the gym a few days per week and do massive amounts of light reps on a leg press machine with their non-dominant leg. Okay, so it ended up being literally like between 960 and 1200 reps each time they went in there. Crazy high reps. Okay, their diets were very similar in terms of calories. Nothing had changed. Okay, they didn't add calories, they didn't decrease calories, but they wanted to see what happened overall with fat burning. Well, the results were pretty alarming actually. You would think that they'd go into the gym and they'd work that leg and that leg would lean out. Well, all the subjects lost on average 0.3 pounds of fat. But what was crazy was that they lost fat in their torso more so than the leg that was trained. So what does this tell us? Well, this tells us that they were moving a big body part and triggering a spike in their metabolism that caused them to burn fat. That's awesome. But why didn't they burn fat in their leg? They burned fat in their torso. Well, there's a lot of holes that we could poke in this and a lot of reasons to why this could have happened. Could have been inflammation, it could have been the fact that because they were training their legs so much, there was so much inflammation and cortisol that it stopped fat burning. So then it begs the question, if we have localized fat burning restriction, basically if we have localized inhibition of fat burning, then what's to say that we can't have localized burning of fat? And this is where the genetics come into play. So I've got some pretty cool solutions for you. And this is all based on research. Since we don't understand for sure whether we can reduce fat in one area or not, what I can do is give you the genetic makeup and things that you can do to help boost your genetic potential to potentially burn more fat in those given areas, but at the very least, burn more fat overall. So the first thing we have to look at is something called the WNT signaling pathway. Okay, this WNT signaling pathway sounds complex and it is, but I'm gonna spare you the details on it. Basically, the WNT signaling pathway has to do with certain genes, one gene in particular, LRP5. This LRP5 gene has been shown to play a role in how we distribute fat. When we have a higher expression of LRP5, we burn more fat in the abdomen and we store more fat potentially in the gluteals. Okay, now if we have less LRP5, as demonstrated with knockdown mice, where they took mice and they got rid of the LRP5, well, they store more fat in the abdomen and burn more in the gluteals. So what are we getting at here? It means that yes, there is a genetic predisposition to where you burn fat, but there's ways around this. Here is, hear me out, where keto and fasting come in. And I highly recommend that you consider this, even if it's just for small amounts. Okay, keto and fasting increase, of course, ketones. And these ketones saturate our cells in such a way where it improves gene expression. So what this means is if you are already having somewhat of a genetic potential to burn fat, if you expose those cells to ketones, they actually burn more fat. It makes your genes more powerful. So if you have good genes, it makes them more powerful. Here's the thing, if you have bad genes, it actually helps course correct them. I'll spare you the gory details, but basically what ketones do is they unlock the blueprint. They unlock the genetic library of your body so that your body can activate portions of its genetic code that it normally wouldn't be able to. Now, if you're interested in starting keto, I would recommend for anyone that's starting keto or is doing keto, check out Thrive Market down below. Just a little bit of a side note, but still cool to mention. I've created keto boxes and fasting boxes. They're an online membership-based grocery store. Huge sponsor of this channel, but the coolest thing is that I've been able to compile my own grocery boxes, my own grocery items in Thrive boxes for people that watch my videos to check out. So that way you can head on over to Thrive, you can see what Thomas would order, what Thomas would buy at the grocery store, and you can get those boxes delivered right to your doorstep. So highly, highly, highly recommended. I've got keto boxes, fasting boxes, I've got thyroid boxes, hormone optimization boxes, all things based on different videos that I've done and things like that, just to make life easy. So check them out down below in the description. Another piece that you can add to the equation is a low dose of 5 milligrams lithium orotate. Okay, so remember this whole LRP5 thing that I talked about? Well, it's been shown that low dose lithium orotate activates the expression of LRP5. So it expresses LRP5. So it means you get more of that gene expression, I guess, that would allow you to burn fat in the abdomen. That's really good. That's that fat distribution piece that we want. So think about it like this. You add low dose lithium orotate, and that's gonna change your genetic structure ever so slightly. And then you go keto, or you do some periods of intermittent fasting for 16 hours, 3-4 days per week. And therefore, you end up having the saturation of those cells and those genes. So now you've changed your genes through lithium, but now you're expressing them and helping them get more out of their own potential by doing keto and fasting. The other thing that's really important to note is when we look at these two studies, okay, the American Journal of Physiology study versus the National Strength and Conditioning Association study, there was one glaring difference. The American Journal of Physiology study was in a fasted state. The other one wasn't necessarily. So what that means to us is that perhaps when you're in a fasted state and your body is saturated in ketones and your cells are saturated in ketones, maybe then you have the genetic ability to spot reduce, simply because your genetics are changing, your genes are changing. There's not enough evidence out there to prove or disprove that during a ketogenic state or a fasting state, we have more likelihood of burning fat in one particular area. So train fasted, okay, try going keto, even if it's cyclical, where you go like 1 week on, 1 week off, 1 week on, 1 week off. Practice intermittent fasting so that you can get those ketones to saturate your cells a little bit more. Okay, try taking 5 milligrams low dose lithium orotate, nothing like the pharmaceutical amounts we're supposed to be taking. And also make sure that you're consistently spiking your epinephrine and norepinephrine by doing bouts of HIIT. So I think when you combine all the stuff together, you really end up with a pretty solid way to at least increase your chances of spot reducing fat. So as always, I want to make sure that you do keep it locked in here on my channel. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. And also do yourself and this channel a favor by checking out Thrive Market down below in the description. And I'll see you in the next video.